What is the difference between computer languages, programming languages, and normal languages?
We say, I think the reason that we call it a language is to communicate, right? We are communicating with each other right now. Just like that, to communicate with a machine, we also need a language.
Of all these, I think over 600 programming languages, do you have any favorites?
Well, I haven't tried all of them, so I can't pick a complete favorite.
It would be something like C# or Java.
Really?
Yeah, probably.
I don't really have a favorite. I'm more, and that is also what this education teaches you, is to be more language agnostic.
I really love C# and Java. They don't have lots of magic, you know, lots of magical libraries that you, if you don't know that, you could not manage to solve that problem, but it's kind of more simple.
Describe me the feeling when you really created something which had impact there.
Yeah,
what do you feel about it?
It's a huge relief, actually. Like when you write something and it just works, you know? Because at least for me, you always think the negative first. Like you write the code and you run it. The moment where you run, there's a little bit of delay, like the 5 seconds or maybe like 3 seconds. It depends from computer to computer. But those 3 seconds, you think. And either an error will pop up or you see the command prompt or the output or the user interface. But either of these will happen. And like that moment is kind of intense.
But what if bugs keep coming up all the time and it doesn't work? What do you do?
That's how it goes. But you get used to it. You just need to Google it. That's the part where you work on most. Like you'll always have bugs. That's your job.
If you need to choose between brain power or computer power, what would you choose?
Computer power, of course.
Well, to be able to use computer power, you need to have some brain power at first.
Lots of great stuff is being developed by great brains, but the product itself is bigger than the human brain.
Definitely computer power. A good example, chess engines. Right now, like, there are many grandmasters in the world. There are like many people who play chess competitively, right? And they all rely on engines. Like all games are evaluated with the help of the engines. There's a huge chess database that records every move so that you can track the games. And they, like there are chess engines that can beat grandmasters easily. Like, there are chess engines that challenges grandmasters to death. So that's a good example of a brain power versus computer power.